Hello friends, once again welcome to your favorite pharma channel, Ram Pharma Academy. In today's lecture, we are going to discuss about adrenergic drugs with their structure and IUPAC name. It is important for Medicinal Chemistry 1, B Pharmacy 2nd year, Semester 4 examination as per your PCI syllabus. In the examination, you will be asked to draw the structure and give its IUPAC name. There, this video will be useful for you. If you are preparing for pharmacy examinations, so please watch our videos till the end. Friends, I have to take lot of efforts to make this type of videos, so please like and share the video with all your friends and don't forget to subscribe to our channel for upcoming videos. It takes only few seconds for the sharing, so please share it. Let's start with our today's topic, that is sympathomimetic agents. I have taken this classification from your PCI syllabus copy, in which they have classified these drugs into direct acting drugs, indirect acting agents, and agents with mixed mechanism. Direct acting agents are from norepinephrine and up to xylometazoline. What are direct acting agents? Direct acting agents are the drugs which can directly bind with the either alpha or beta receptors and produces the agonistic activity. Those drugs are known as direct acting sympathomimetic agents. And next class is the indirect acting agents. So what are indirect acting agents? Indirect acting agents are the drugs which increases the concentration of norepinephrine at the site of synapse. It can be done by various ways, like by increasing the release of norepinephrine or decreasing the reuptake mechanism of norepinephrine, or by decreasing its metabolism by the COMT and MAO. Last classification is the agents with mixed mechanism. Examples are ephedrine and metaraminol. What are agents with mixed mechanism? They have both actions, like they can directly bind with the alpha or beta receptor and produces the agonistic activity, or indirectly they can increase the level of norepinephrine in the synapse. In this way also they can act as a sympathomimetic agents. So as they have both mechanisms, they are classified as agents with mixed mechanism. So friends, in this video we are going to cover only structures and how to give their IUPAC names. So friends, watch the video till the end to understand all the structures with their IUPAC names. Let's take first example, that is dopamine. As you know, dopamine, adrenaline and noradrenaline all are the catecholamines present in the body biologically or naturally. What are catecholamines? They contain this catecholmoiety in which one, two hydroxy groups are present, means two hydroxy groups are present adjacent to each other. Then there is presence of this ethylene linkage CH2CH2, and finally the amino terminal. How to give IUPAC name of this molecule? First, give the numbering to the benzene ring 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Start the numbering from the parahydroxyl group, giving it first number. Then give numbering to the ethylene linkage 1 and 2. Now, give the IUPAC name. 4 into bracket 2 amino ethyl benzene 1, 2 diol. Now, I will discuss how to give this IUPAC name. 4 comes from the position of this group at the 4th position of benzene ring. Then at 2nd position, you can see there is presence of amino group. Hence, the name is 4-2-amino-ethyl-benzene-1,2-diol. Means the IUPAC name of the dopamine is 4 into bracket 2 amino ethyl benzene 1 2 diol. Because hydroxy groups are present, the suffix for the IUPAC name will be ol, O-L. And why diol? Because 2 hydroxy groups are present, it is diol. The next molecule is norepinephrine or the noradrenaline. If you know the structure of dopamine, you can easily draw the structure of norepinephrine. You just have to put one hydroxyl group at the beta position or on the first carbon, and it forms the norepinephrine. How to give IUPAC name of norepinephrine? You have to give this similar numbering like this. Then the IUPAC name of molecule is R(4)2-amino(1-hydroxyethyl)benzene(1,2-diol). This R comes from the stereochemistry of this hydroxyl group at the beta position, because in SAR, structure activity relationship, we have discussed that R isomer has the potent action compared to the S isomer. If you want to learn the structure activity relationship, I have made one video, link is given this in the description, please go and watch that video. That question is also important for your examination. Let's come to our structure. Now you can see at fourth position, similar to dopamine, you have to give the nomenclature 2-amino(1-hydroxyethyl)benzene(1,2-diol). So the IUPAC name of norepinephrine will be R, because of this hydroxyl group R, 4, 2-amino, this 2-amino, 1-hydroxy ethyl, CH2 group, then this benzene, and 1,2-diol. Let's take next example, that is epinephrine. If you know the structure of norepinephrine, you can easily draw the structure of epinephrine also. You just have to put one methyl group at the amino terminal, and it forms the epinephrine. We have discussed the synthesis of these catecholamines, dopamine, adrenaline, and noradrenaline. I have made one video. I have given this link in the description. So go and watch that video also. Biosynthesis of catecholamines. Let's give the numbering to this molecule 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, similar to dopamine and norepinephrine. And its IUPAC name is R(4)2-hydroxy(2-methylamino)ethyl)benzene(1,2-diol). R for stereochemistry of hydroxyl group. Then 4, 1-hydroxy(2-methylamino)(2-methylamino)ethyl), this ethyl group. Then this benzyl, and finally 1,2-diol. So the IUPAC name of epinephrine will be R for this hydroxyl group, 4, 1-hydroxy(2-methylamino)ethyl), this benzene, 1,2-diol. Okay friends, these questions are very important, so watch the video till the end, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel, and please share the video with all your friends so that they also can get the benefit of this video. Next molecule is methyl dopa. Give the numbering. Numbering is quite different. Okay, like this. You have to give the numbering. This 2S comes from the stereochemistry of this amino group at the second position. It is 2S configuration. Then at second position, you can see there is presence of amino group. That's why 2-amino. Then at third position, this catechol moiety is there. We have to give the name to this catechol moiety, like 3,4-dihydroxyphenyl(2-methyl). At the second position, this methyl group is there. That's a 2-methyl. Then propanoic acid. Why propanoic acid? Because 3 carbon containing longest carbon chain, 1, 2, and 3. That's why propanoic acid. Once again, we will see the name 2S for the stereochemistry. Then 2-amino. This 2-amino, 3, this 3. 3,4-dihydroxyphenyl. 3,4-dihydroxyphenyl 2-methyl, this methyl group 2-methyl, and this acid propanoic acid 1,2,3 carbon containing acid propanoic acid. So this is the IUPAC name of methyl DOPA. Next molecule is phenylephrine. If you know the structure of epinephrine, you can easily draw the structure of phenylephrine. You just have to remove the hydroxyl group at para position of epinephrine and it forms the phenylephrine. Let's give the numbering to this molecule. Start numbering from the hydroxyl group on the phenyl ring. Then give next numbering to the ethylene linkage. And now give the IUPAC name. Why this R? Because of the stereochemistry of this hydroxyl group. Then this side chain is present at the third position. That's why this 3. 1 hydroxy. Hydroxyl group is present at first position. That's why 1 hydroxy. Then at second position, this second position, there is presence of 2 methyl amino. See this 2 methyl amino ethyl and then this phenol. Because when hydroxyl group is present on the benzene ring, 1 hydroxyl group, it is known as phenol. Let's discuss the name once again. R for the stereochemistry of hydroxyl group. Then at this side chain is present at third position, therefore this 3, 1 hydroxy, 2 methyl amino, then this ethyl group, and finally the phenol, because we have considered this as a derivative of phenol. Let's take next example, isoproterenol. If you know the structure of epinephrine, you just have to remove the methyl group from the amino terminal and replace it with the isopropyl group, and it forms isoproterenol. This isoproterenol is also known as isoprenaline. Let's give the numbering to the molecule. Similar to epinephrine, we have to give the IUPAC name. You just have to change the name at this position. Okay friends, see, instead of isopropyl amino in epinephrine, you put the methyl amino. That is the only difference. So the IUPAC name of isoproterenol is 1 hydroxy, 2 isopropyl amino, this ethyl benzene 1,2-diol. Okay friends, got the nomenclature IUPAC name of isoproterenol. The next example is terbutaline. This terbutaline is quite little bit different because it is not a catechol amine. It contains the 1,3-diol moiety, which is known as resorcinol. We have discussed this part in the structure activity relationship. Please go and watch that video also. Link is given in the description. Let's give the numbering first. It's very easy to give the IUPAC name. See, at this fifth position, the side chain is present. We have to give the name to the side chain. 5. Then 2 tertiary butyl amino, 1 hydroxy ethyl. At this first position, there is a 1 hydroxy group present. 1 hydroxy ethyl, this 1 and 2 carbon, CH2 is known as ethyl benzene 1,3-diol, because at the first and third position there is presence of hydroxyl group, that's why it is 1,3-diol. Okay friends, let's take next example, salbutamol. Similar to terbutaline, you just have to change the hydroxyl group at the meta position with hydroxymethyl group. See, first give the numbering, then the IUPAC name. At fourth position, you can see the presence of salbutamol. 4, 2 tertiary butyl amino, 2 tertiary butyl amino, 1 hydroxyethyl, 1 hydroxyethyl. Then at second position, you can see there is presence of hydroxymethyl group. CH2OH is known as hydroxymethyl group. And finally, this is phenol. Okay, friends, there is a difference between the terbutaline and salbutamol. Terbutaline contains hydroxyl group at the 1 and 3 positions, and salbutamol contains only one hydroxyl group directly attached with the phenyl ring, and another hydroxyl group is in the form of hydroxymethyl group. Okay, friends, then let's take next example, butyl-terol. Give the numbering to the molecule first, then its IUPAC name. The IUPAC name of this molecule is little bit different. At fourth position, at this fourth position, 2 tertiary butyl amino, 2 tertiary butyl amino, 1 hydroxyethyl, 1 hydroxy, then this ethyl 1,2 carbons, 1,2 phenylene, 1. This phenyl group is attached at the first and second position, that's why it is 1,2 phenylene bis, because these two groups are present, that's why it is bis. 4 methyl benzoate. Why 4 methyl benzoate? Because you can see this molecule is phenyl ring, benzene ring with COOH group is known as benzoic acid, and at the fourth position there is presence of one methyl group, that's why 4 methyl benzoate. So the IUPAC name of butyl-terol is 2 tertiary butyl amino, 2 tertiary butyl amino, 1 hydroxyethyl, this 1 hydroxyethyl, 1,2 phenylene, because of phenyl ring at the first and second position, 1,2 phenylene, bis 4 methyl benzoate, bis, because they are two times 4 methyl benzoate, because it is ester, that's why IUPAC name ends with the ATE, that is ester. Let's take next example, dobutamine. There is a difference between dopamine and dobutamine. If you, in the structure of dopamine, you have to put this moiety at the amino terminal. Okay, this part is from the dopamine with which you have to attach this group and forms the dobutamine. Let's give the IUPAC name to this molecule, numbering to this molecule, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, friends, like this you have to give the numbering. Now let's discuss the IUPAC name. This 4 comes from this position 4, then second 2, this 2, 4 for this 4, then this 4 is for this fourth hydroxy group. 4 hydroxy phenyl 2 butenyl, 1, 2, 3, 4 is butane, and it is joined at second position, and that's why name is 2 butenyl. Then this amino ethyl, this ethyl, benzene, this benzene, 1,2-diol. Once again, we'll see the IUPAC name of this molecule. This 4, 2, 4 for this 4. Then 4 hydroxyphenyl, 4-hydroxyphenyl 2-butenyl for this 2-butyl group, amino, ethyl, this CH2 CH2 linkage, ethyl, benzene, 1,2-diol. Okay friends, let's take next example. It is clonidine. Now structures are different from the previous structures because these drugs acts on the alpha receptors. Let's first give the numbering to this molecule, 1,1,2,3,4,5 for this heterocyclic ring. All of you knows the heterocyclic ring. Heterocyclic rings are the rings which contains elements other than the carbon, are known as heterocyclic rings. Here you can see in this ring contains nitrogen in the ring, that's why it is heterocyclic ring. Let's give the IUPAC name to this molecule. On this nitrogen there is presence of this substitution, hence we have to give name to this substitution. It's very easy, 2,6-dichlorophenyl, because at second and sixth position there is presence of chlorine group. You can see here 2,6-dichloro, because they are present for two times, dichlorophenyl, 4,5-dihydroimidazole, 2-amine. This heterocyclic is actually form imidazole. Imidazole structure is like this, nitrogen, and it has hydrogen over here and double bond. This is the structure of imidazole. But in case of our clonidine molecule, the bond between the fourth and fifth position is reduced, and means two hydrogens are added. That's why IUPAC name contains 4,5-dihydroimidazole 2-amine. Okay friends, got it? Because other molecules also contains this heterocyclic ring. Next molecule is naphazoline. Give the numbering to this molecule. So this is the IUPAC name of naphazoline, 2. At second position, this 2, this substitution is there. You know the name of this moiety, that is, it comes from the naphthalene. So naphthalene, as it is attached at the first position, 1-yl. If it has attached at the second position, it might be 2-yl. But here it is attached at the first position, therefore 1-yl. Then methyl, this methyl CH2 linkage, 4,5-dihydroimidazole, 4,5-dihydroimidazole. The next molecule is oxymetazoline. First give the numbering. Now the IUPAC name. At second position, you can see at sixth position is presence of this tertiary butyl, therefore 6-tertiary butyl. Then at third position, this heterocyclic ring is present. We know the name of this heterocyclic ring already, 4,5-dihydroimidazole, 4,5-dihydroimidazole, and as it is attached to this second position, therefore it is 2-yl methyl for this CH2 linkage, and then 2,4-dimethylphenol, because at second position and fourth position there are two methyl groups, therefore 2,4-dimethyl and then this phenol. Once again we will see the name of this molecule, 6-tertiary butyl. At third position this attachment is there, heterocyclic ring, therefore 4,5-dihydroimidazole, 4,5-dihydroimidazole, 2-yl, methyl, 2,4-dimethyl, then this phenol, benzene ring with hydroxyl group, is known as phenol. Next molecule is xylometazoline. Let's give the numbering to the xylometazoline. It is similar to previous molecule, only you have to replace the hydroxyl group, you have to remove, then give the IUPAC name. At second position, here at second position, the side chain is present, therefore 4-tertiary butyl, 2,6-dimethyl, benzyl for this phenyl and CH2 group. Benzyl is phenyl plus CH2 group, is known as benzyl. Then at fourth position, 4 and 5, we have already seen this part. The bond between 4 and 5 is reduced, that's why 4,5-dihydroimidazole. Okay, next molecule is hydroxyamphetamine. You know the structure of amphetamine? You just have to put the hydroxyl group at the para position and it forms hydroxyamphetamine. Give the numbering to molecule. Then its IUPAC name. It's very easy. At fourth position, you can see this side chain is present. Therefore, 4. Then at second position of the side chain, amino group is present. Therefore, 2-aminopropyl. 2-amino. Then this propyl. 1, 2, 3 carbon containing. Alkene is propane. That's why 2-propyl. And you know this molecule is phenol, benzene ring with one hydroxyl group, phenol. So the IUPAC name of hydroxyamphetamine is very easy, 4-2-aminopropylphenol. The next molecule is propyl hexadrine. Give the IUPAC, numbering first, then its IUPAC name. At first position, you can see there is presence of this cyclohexyl ring. Okay. 6 member containing saturated ring is known as cyclohexane, and is, as it is substituent, we have to put the YL. So 1 cyclohexyl, N methyl, because 1 methyl group is present on the amino group, 1 N methyl, 2 propanamine, because this amino group is present at second position, therefore the amine is known as 2-propaneamine. Why propane? Because it contains 1, 2, 3 carbons. 1, 2, 3 carbons. Okay. The next molecule is pseudoephedrine. You can see this molecule contains these two stereocenters or asymmetric centers. And you know the formula to find out the number of stereoisomers. It is 2^n, where N is number of asymmetric centers. Number of asymmetric centers means 2^2. Pseudoephedrine. 2^2 N. 2^2 is equal to 4. So 4 isomers are possible for the ephedrine if it has the stereochemistry as S or RR, it is known as pseudoephedrine. And if it has the stereochemistry as RS or SR, then that molecule is known as ephedrine. Okay, friends, about this optical isomerism, we will discuss in another video, because in examination you will be asked that question also. How optical isomerism affects the biological activity? That question we will cover in the upcoming videos. First, give the numbering to this molecule and then IUPAC name. Why this 1S and 2S? Because the stereochemistry at the first and second position. Then at second position, you can see there is presence of this methyl amino group. Methyl amino group. Then at first position, one phenyl ring is there. One phenyl. Then this carbon chain, 1, 2, 3, is propane. And at first position, there is one hydroxyl group. Okay, friends. This one propanol. It is one propanol. So an IUPAC name of pseudoephedrine is very easy. Let's take next example. That is ephedrine. The name of ephedrine is very similar to pseudoephedrine. You just have to change the stereochemistry. Instead of RS, you have to change it to SR or RS. Okay, friends. Then I think this is the last molecule, metaraminol. Give the numbering first. Then the IUPAC name. At third position, I forgot to give the numbering to benzene ring. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So at third position, at this third position, this group is side chain is present. 2 amino, 1 hydroxypropyl, 1 hydroxy, then this propyl, and finally phenol. Once again, we'll see the name. This at third position, 2 amino, 1 hydroxypropyl, 1 hydroxy propyl phenol, this phenol. Okay, friends, I think this is the end of the tutorial. So please like and share the video, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching. Goodbye. Take care.